The Navy is still evaluating that, Aaron. They say the next update should come in the middle of August. Now, behind me is the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard, where the USS Miami is berthed. But the Navy says without the actions of the firefighters, well, deciding whether or not the Miami's shipworthy wouldn't even be, wouldn't even be an option.
River where 2 months ago many of them rushed to put out a fire aboard a nuclear submarine. Representatives of New Hampshire fire departments gathered to receive the thanks of the U.S. Senate.
I'm so honored to be here today to recognize everyone who showed so much courage on that day.
The two U.S. senators from New Hampshire said the actions of firefighters that day were heroic given the conditions they faced.
When you heard about the thick smoke that was so black, you couldn't even see the hand in front of your face. Hearing about how they worked together with the crew of the Miami.
The fire aboard the USS Miami broke out in a forward compartment on May 23rd. It took about 10 hours to put out, during which time firefighters from the shipyard and 23 other departments worked in teams to enter the hull and fight the fire. The fire caused an estimated $400 million in damage.
We're in the process of assessing the damage, cleaning up, and determining what repairs will be necessary to restore the forward compartment.
Speaking on behalf of the firefighters was the president of the union, who said fighting a fire aboard a submarine wasn't much different from fighting one in a building.
You lose your sense of sight, your sense of smell, you have your sense of hearing, along with your sense of touch.
And while they appreciate all the accolades,
some folks say it's heroic. Our guys say we're just doing our job.
As you take a live look at the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard, where the Miami is berthed, Lang also said that the ability of all the departments to work together is a testament to the training they received, but he also said they can always use more training. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.